Hey y'all, hey. So today I'm going to be working on a design for a financial office. So we're going to start with the columns since they're going to have the designs. So I'm going to first apply the base coat, which is the gold. I'm going to do about three applications because to me the gold was coming out pretty thin. I use Modern Masters. And I wanted the triangles to look consistent. So I did three coats. I rolled on the bulk of it first and I did the cutting at the end. And instead of using a brush on cutting, I used this little rolly pad thing that kind of is supposed to be like preventing the colors to get on the other wall. I honestly should have just used my brush. So I'm basically prepping the walls first before I start doing the measurements, before I start applying the tape. So I want to make sure that the columns are dry first with the gold. And while I'm waiting for this to dry, I'm going to work on the other wall. Now the other one I'm going to be working on is pretty long and it's just going to be purple. And because I wanted to make sure that it wasn't going to be blotchy, I wanted to also do three applications of the paint to this wall as well. So as you see, I'm applying the paint first and at the end I'm going to cut it. But when I do cut it, I only cut it twice and I put enough paint on the brush for it to apply thick. Once the coat dries fully, then I can see where their spaces is going to be. So just tune in to the process. Okay, so right now I have already applied the next two coats. And right now I'm just measuring. So I'm measuring out the triangles. Now because I need the triangles to be perfect, I am measuring them by halves and wholes. So horizontally, if I did 12 inches, a 12 inch line, I go to my 6 inch, I measure it up 12 inches, and then I make the perfect triangle. It sounds confusing. And it is confusing when you do it because I lose count on how many, you know, if I did 24, I know I have to go to the middle of 12. If I did 26, I know I have to go into the middle of 13. So you have to just pay attention to the measurements. After I measure it all out, I am gridding it out with a pencil and then I'm going above the pencil. I'm going over the pencil and I'm applying the tape. And the tape is going to grid out the triangles, and so it's going to block off the gold, and so that way after I apply a paint over top of it and I remove the tape, you'll see the pattern. Right now I'm just slowing it down and showing you how I am measuring out the triangles. This is actually a long process, so I'm basically seeing where I'm going to apply the triangles. That part is freestyle, but when it comes to the application, you really do have to measure it because your angles all have to be even. Even though there's different sizes, the angles all should be the same. That's how you get, I don't want to say it's like perfect, but that's how you get the best results in reference to the shape itself. Also, I'm doing different lengths. I'm doing 24 inch horizontal lines and I'm dividing that in half. I'm doing 10 inch horizontal lines and I'm dividing that in half. I'm doing 28 inch horizontal lines. And as you see, I'm using a yellow leveler, which has the measurements. And then I am using a long gray leveler that allows me to make the longer lines. Also, it could be a little difficult to apply these triangles because I want to make sure that I'm not doing too much. I just want to give a cool, clean, abstract, but very uniform look, which is a total oxymoron. But I'm doing triangles that aim up, then aim down, and they go inside the triangles on the other side. But at the end of the day, I just want to make sure all my angles are perfect. that's what gives it this a certain look. So the measuring part, it can be extremely annoying. So I don't prefer to do this particular design because it really takes a long time. Also, even though I'm measuring the lines and the angles itself, I'm still paying attention to how I apply the other lines because I still want it to be uniform. And sometimes your measurements can still be off a little bit. So it's just important to pay attention to how the other triangles are lying. So the one thing about this tape is that sometimes it comes off the walls. So when I apply the over color, which is that cream color that's on the other walls, I kind of hit the corners of the triangles that I saw lifting up. And it kind of acts as a paste a little bit. So I applied those patches. That's why you see like spots around. But in this case, I did the corners and cut it first. And then I went over it with the cream color. Also, I used two coats. This was a really good paint, so I was only used two coats. But before I did my second coat, I actually wanted to start working on the logo. And while I finished the logo, then I went back over it and did my second coat of the cream. So I just wanted to make sure that I was utilizing all my time correctly. So right now, I'm working on the logo itself. And I'm just eyeing the measurements so that it can make sense. I'm making sure that the logo isn't directly in the middle of the wall. So I measured it from each corner so that it was like perfectly in the middle. I'm not using any vinyl with this. I'm doing freehand, just making sure that I use the green tape, but just to make sure that the word itself is straight. The place is called In the Moment. So, and it's a clock incorporated in the logo. So I'm just making sure that I'm doing it as close as possible to the digital logo itself. Yeah, self-love, self-love, self-love. I also added purple random triangles in the design to tie in that purple from the main accent wall. But I am really in love with the results. The process is a whole headache. However, the results are beautiful. But I must say that this is the second time I actually did this design and it came out really good. I have to pat myself on the back. Kudos to me. So I'm actually looking forward to the interior designer to put everything together, and I will be sure to post the final results on how the design came together on my Instagram, which is painting_pretty. So make sure you guys click on the like button. If you want to leave a comment, do that, but definitely subscribe to the channel and feel free to share. I will see you soon, boo.